What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about building complex surfaces inside of Revit. So when it comes to building those wild and interesting building designs in Revit, we have to rely on the massing environment. Massing environment allows us to make complex shapes, irregular shapes inside of Revit. Now, to get from an irregular surface to a building facade, we have to know how to build these complex surfaces inside of Revit, how to apply different materials, different paneling, and so on. So that's what I want to talk about in this video. I'm just going to showing you just the approach and the tools that we have on hand inside of Revit for these types of projects and these types of design solutions. Now, before I get into the actual video, I'd just like to take a moment to tell you about my course on exactly this topic. So, massing in Revit, complex designs in Revit. It's available on my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to include a link just below in the description of this video and up in the cards above, so be sure to check it out. There I have over 130 hours of content for Revit, ranging from many different skill levels and also many different areas inside of Revit. So it's definitely a good place to learn pretty much everything that there is to know inside of Revit. Now also there you can find all of my templates, you can find some really high quality Revit families, and also we have a plugin, so you can check that out if you're interested. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see here, I am in Revit and I'm at the home screen. So I'm just going to go here to new and I'm going to go with the custom Balkan Architect template. As I said, that's the one from my website and the link is going to be up in the cards above. Also, this might be a good time to mention, make sure to subscribe, like, and share this video. It really means a lot to me and helps you helps remind you about my new upcoming videos. Okay, so as you can see, here we are at the kind of at level one, and to work in the massing environment, which is exactly what we're going to be doing, it requires you to go here to Massing and Site, turn on Show Mass, so this is like a global on-off switch for massing in Revit, and then you go to In-Place Mass. So now we can actually get the massing environment and we can start creating our complex geometry. I'm just going to leave it at Mass 1 for the name, and as you can see, our levels are going to become grayed out, so pretty much anything that was done in the project environment gets grayed out, and now we're in the massing environment. So now let's start creating our surface. So because this is going to be kind of like a facade surface, what I'm going to do is just go here and place a spline. Let's use this. So just, I don't know, something like this, just a kind of a simple spline. Go to the modify tool and then go to the 3D view, and here we go. Here we have that spline. We can edit it even further to make it a bit more irregular if we want. But now to turn this into our facade surface, we just go here to create form, and as you can see, it's now a surface. Now I'm just going to extend this a little bit more up, and now to make this surface a bit more interesting, I can select the top line, and then I can kind of change the elements a little bit, perhaps. Yeah. Just use these points and then move them around a little bit. I can move these edge points. Okay, that might be a bit too much. So there we go, it's already starting to become irregular. Now to add even more complexity or kind of shape to this surface, what I can do next is just select the entire surface, go here to add profile, and then I can add an additional profile here in the middle, and then we can play around with that profile so we can even move that around to give it even more kind of complexity. So anyways, once you're happy with the shape, now let's talk about how do we turn this kind of generic geometry into actual building components. So you can select that surface by using the tab key, and then here we have the divide surface tool. So when you click on the divide surface, it's going to, well, divide that surface, and it's just going to apply something that looks like a rectangular pattern. But if you go here into the properties, it's going to say no pattern. So currently we don't really have a pattern here. So what you want to do is you want to assign a pattern. So a pattern can be assigned here in the properties. You just open up the properties. So you just select the surface, which is now this kind of pattern. And then here in the properties, you can apply different patterns. So you can have facades that have like a half step pattern like this, kind of like bricks. Or you can have facades that follow a different pattern like these weird arrows, if that's something you're into. We can, of course, have hexagons and so on, and you can basically apply anything. In this case, let's just stick to a rectangular pattern. Now, even though this is a rectangular pattern, we can turn off grids U or V. So you can actually turn these grids off. Now, this is really going to depend on project to project. In most cases, you want both U and V grids. Now, moving forward, when it comes to display, you can actually turn off this pattern here. So you can turn it off temporarily if you don't want to see it. And the reason it's kind of black like this, I think it's in gray mode. I like to go here into the shaded mode. Sometimes it might change that a little bit. In this case, well, it didn't help too much. So we're stuck with this kind of dark-ish shape. Okay, so we have divided our surface into simple kind of rectangles, into panels, so to speak. So how do we now apply some actual building panels? So you might have aluminum panels, you might have glass panels. You're probably going to be applying some sort of a facade to these to this division of panels. So how do you do that? Well, for that, we have to create a curtain panel to fit on this facade, on this shape. So you create that by going here to the file menu, then you go to new, and then you create a new family. So you have to choose the family template that's called metric curtain wall panel pattern based. So metric curtain panel pattern based. So it's based on this pattern. That's why it's called pattern based. So you just select that, you hit open, and it's going to open up the kind of design environment for creating these profiles, or for creating these panels. Sorry. Okay, so to create the panel, you can use just regular kind of massing tools to create that. What I'm going to do in this case, before I make any changes, I just want to make sure that the grid is set up to the same thing as I have inside of the project here. So you can do that by going, for example, to the south elevation, and then here you can just quickly measure, like, how tall is this? It's 1.2 by 3 meters or something, 2 by 3 meters. So I can come back here, and then this is 3000 by 3000. So that's 3 meters by 3 meters. So I can just say, okay, let's make it 2 meters on one side. Oops, not, that's 2000 millimeters. Just so we're a bit more accurate to whatever we have here. If you don't know how I did that, I just hover over the bottom edge here, or the top edge, and then you can edit that pattern. Also, you can change the pattern. So if I select this, it doesn't have to be a rectangular pattern. You can create a panel for octagonal patterns. You can create it for triangular patterns. So you choose the pattern here the same way you do it inside of the project here. When you select this, whatever pattern you have assigned here, you just make sure to use the same pattern inside of the family as well. In this case, we're just sticking to a rectangle. Okay, so let's say I want this to be a glass pattern, so I'm just going to select the whole rectangle, go to create form, make sure it's a little rectangle. The height can be something really small, like 5 millimeters. And then here for the material, let's go with glass. So let's wait for a second. Yeah, so glass. There we go, perfect. Okay, so now once we have the glass panel, let's add some sort of a frame around that panel. So what I'm going to do for that is first turn on the thin lines so I can see what's going on here. Then I'm going to go to the point element and just place it here on the reference plane below. So just place it there on the reference plane, and now you can select that point, and as you can see, it has a reference plane, and we can draw on this reference plane. So what I like to do is go to set reference plane, or set work plane, select this reference plane here, and then I can just come in here and draw whatever geometry I want on top of that. So let's create that frame. Now this is obviously going to be a bit oversized, just because I want it to be, well, visual, or kind of I want you to be able to see that. So let's just here come in here, select this line, delete this line, delete. So we have some kind of weird frame that looks like a quarter circle, and let's just select that frame, and so you select the profile, and then you go and select the reference planes below. So you just hold the control key to select both of them, and then you go to create form, and it creates something that looks like this. So we have that glass panel in the middle, and then we have this weird frame around that. So once we have this, make sure to save the family. In this case, I'm not going to, just to keep this quick, but you always want to save the family first, and then you load it into the project. So once you've loaded that into the project, you go to the 3D view, you select the pattern, and then you just go here, and once it's loaded, you can see because it's a rectangle, we've started with the kind of rectangle base, it's going to appear here below the rectangle layout. So you just click on that that family, a rectangular glass panel family, and as you can see now here we have this, and it's made out of glass, and it has that weird panel applied there. And there we go. Also, you have this button to configure the grids if you want. As you can see, you can configure the UV grids, and it's just going to move things around if you want to make changes for that. So we have that option, and there we go. That's how you create these surfaces and that have panels. Obviously, this panel has been tremendously oversimplified, but what you want to do in real life is obviously kind of invest time and make sure that the panel has the complexity required for the project. Now, one more thing that I would like to show you here is, let's just go back to no pattern. Yeah, there we go. So as you remember, no pattern still gives us this rectangular shape unless we turn off the surface. Okay, so we can go back to no pattern, and let's say we want to have panels, but we don't want to stick to a regular kind of panel. We want to have more flexibility. Well, for that, I can go here to surface representation. I can open up this little arrow, and I can turn on the nodes. So once you have the nodes turned on, you can apply something that's called adaptive components to this. So you can build your panels as adaptive components, and adaptive components, as the name would say or indicate, have a bit more functionality and are a bit more, well, adaptive. So let's make a quick adaptive component to apply here as a facade panel. And I'm just going to be generating the same thing as we have here. So this same thing, but it's going to be an adaptive component. And instead of 4 points, we're going to go with 3 points. So let's go here to File, New, Family. And then instead of the curtain panel pattern based, you go down to generic model adaptive, this one, and you hit open. So you're going to notice that it's a bit more kind of simplified. And here, instead of having those points already and having the grid already, here we have the ability to create our own points and our own grid. So you go here to the point tool or point element, and in this case, let's go with 3. You make a broad selection of all 3 points, and then you can make them adaptive. So now it's 1, 2, 3. There we go, 1, 1, 2, 3. Now you can select those points, or you can connect those points by simply selecting 2 of them like this. You go to spline through points, it's going to generate a line through them, or a spline through them. So then when you move 1 point, the line will follow that. And then you just want to select that line and turn it into a reference line like this. So you just click there, reference line, and there we go. And you just repeat the process here. So spline is reference. And again, like this. Spline is reference. Okay, so once we have this triangular panel, now we can select it. Again, just create that extrusion, make sure it's just 5 millimeters, and that it's glass. Okay, here we go, glass, apply. There we go. And now we can also create that profile. So for the profile, just zoom in here closely. You place the point on the reference plane. See here, it's going to report down here. Once I hover over that reference line, so just make sure to place it on that reference line. Then you select the point, you go to set work plane, set it on that point, and then we can create our little rectangle like this. What was it? I think I put an arc here, yeah, just to keep it simple. Perfect, delete this line. Okay, select this, select the reference planes below, just hold the control key to select all of them, create form, and it's going to generate the same thing. In this case, it's a triangle. So now we load this into the project 2, click OK. And now instead of applying that like we did for the previous one, here you can actually specify the points on which this is going to be hosted on. So you can go like that. So you can have like a only half of the panel, and then you can do the other half. So for example, like this. Or you don't have to follow kind of the shape of those the rectangles. You can kind of do it arbitrarily. So as you can see, or you can kind of follow whichever methodology you want to use. So this gives you way more flexibility, way more power, but those adaptive panels adaptive component families are a little bit trickier to set up initially, but as you see, the they are far more flexible and far more powerful. And then once you're done, you just hit finish mass, and this is now inside of your project, and this is now actual geometry inside of Revit, which is really cool. So there you go. Please tell me in the comment section below if you have learned something new in this video. And as I said, I have that entire course that shows you on all actual buildings, actual projects, how to go from just simple geometry, how to make it complicated, how to make it, wild, so to speak, and then how to, turn that into actual building components, turn that into walls, floors, and so on, and have really complicated buildings done completely inside of Revit. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.